Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the protection of the parallel feeders. Before this we have studied the overcurrent protection of the transmission line. Similarly, in this video we are going to study how to protect the feeders. So figure A shows an overcurrent protective scheme which is used for the parallel feeders. So in the figure we can see the diagram for the protection scheme for the parallel feeders. Here there are four sections A, B, C and D. Then the fault has occurred at point F. Then here the bidirectional arrow shows the non-directional relay, whereas the direction shows the directional relay. Now let us see the working. So at the sending end of the feeder, that is at the A and B, the non-directional relays are required. This I have already explained in the figure. Then the double arrow symbol indicates the non-directional relay. At the other end, that is at the end of the feeder in the section C and D, the directional overcurrent relay is required. It is indicated by the single direction arrow. So the arrow mark for the directional relay placed at C and D indicates the relay will operate if the current flows in the direction shown by the arrow. So, if the direction of the current is shown by the arrow, then and then only the relay will operate. Otherwise, relay will remain inoperative. Now, let us consider that fault has occurred at point F. Then the directional relay at D will trip and the direction of the current is reversed. The relay at C does not trip as the current flow is in the normal direction. Let us see this in the figure. Now let us consider that fault has occurred at point F. Now as the fault has occurred at point F, the direction of current will reverse. As a result, the relay at the D will trip, whereas the relay at the C will remain inoperative. Now the relay which is present at B will also trip for the fault F. Thus, the faulty feeder will be isolated and the supply of the healthy feeder is maintained. Now, if we use the non-directional relay at both the section, that is C and D, then the both the relays which are placed at C and D will trip for fault F. Now, as the fault is occurring, the direction is reversed. So, if the non-directional relays are placed at C and D, then both the relays will operate for such a fault condition. This is the undesirable condition. This is not desired as the healthy feeder will also be tripped along with the faulty feeder. Now, due to this very reason, the relays at C and D are directional type of relays, whereas the relays at A and B are non-directional type. Now, for the faults at the feeders, the direction of the current at A and B does not change and hence the relays used at A and B are non-directional relay. So, the direction will only change at the section C and D. As a result, at those sections only directional relays are required, whereas the direction does not change at A and B, hence we can use the non-directional relays. So, in this way we have studied the protection of the parallel feeders. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and do subscribe our channel eKida. Thank you.